Paterson's question. Senator Paterson.
Thank you, Mr. President. My question is to the Minister for Trade, Tourism and Investment, Senator Birmingham. Can the Minister outline the mutual benefits for farmers, businesses, investors and workers when the trade agreement with Indonesia comes into force?
The Minister for Trade, Tourism and Investment, Senator Birmingham.
Thanks, Mr. President. I thank Senator Paterson for his question and his passionate advocacy for increasing trade access for Australian businesses and liberalising trade across the globe. Mr. President, a central pillar of Australia's deepening relationship with Indonesia is the Indonesia-Australia Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement. And we were thrilled that late last week, just prior to President Widodo's visit to Australia, the Indonesian Parliament did what the Australian Parliament did late last year and provided support for that agreement, which will enable its ratification and entry into force over the coming months. This is an outstanding opportunity to finally and fully realise the potential of the economic relationship between Australia and Indonesia. As the Australia-Indonesia Business Council President Phil Turtle said recently, IASEPA has been designed to deliver balanced outcomes for both countries and puts emphasis on cooperative initiatives. And we want to work with Indonesia to build its economy and its skill base by supporting investment and genuine partnerships across sectors like education, meat, grains and elsewhere. Because, Mr. President, as Senator Payne has indicated already, a successful and stable Indonesia is central for and good for Australia and our region, as well as, of course, for Indonesia. There are multiple benefits from IASEPA across a range of sectors, including in the services industries, mining services, health, hospital and aged care, education, I've already mentioned, architecture and engineering. There are enhanced opportunities into the Australian market for areas of ambition of Indonesia, such as the electric vehicle market, as well as opportunities in terms of enhanced work rights around working holiday makers who make such a valuable contribution to our economy. Our agricultural, our steel making and other sectors all gain significantly, whether it's 575,000 access for cattle, 500,000 tonnes of grain, around 455 semi-loads of oranges,
Order,
a
Birmingham.
Range of different categories.
Senator Paterson, a supplementary question.
Thank you, Mr. President. Can the minister advise the Senate what else the government is doing to build a more resilient economy and create opportunities in new markets for our exporters, tourism operators and international education providers to sustain jobs?
Senator Birmingham.
Mr. President, our government has always recognised that the more Australian farmers and businesses are able to access choice and diversity across the globe, the better it is for them to build their resilience, particularly in some of the challenging times that we face at present. That's why, as a government, we pursued aggressively trade opportunities with Japan, Korea, China, the implementation of the Trans-Pacific Partnership, and, of course, in line with the passage of the Indonesia Agreement through this parliament, we welcomed the passage of the Hong Kong Free Trade Agreement, which entered into force last month on 17 January, which was acknowledged as being important for insurance, banking and fintech sectors. The Peru Agreement, I'm pleased to inform the Senate, will come into force tomorrow, the 11th of February. And that has been recognised as opening up a level playing field for Australian mining, engineering and technological services companies, excellent opportunities across other services industries, including also in goods, wine, sheep meat, kangaroo meat and other sectors will all benefit from that diversification.
Order. Senator Paterson, a final supplementary question.
Thank you, Mr. President. Can the minister inform the Senate of other recent good news on the trade front?
Senator Birmingham.
Mr. President, 6 years of creating new market access opportunities is delivering for Australia. ABS data last week showed Australia posted our largest ever calendar year trade surplus in 2019. That was a trade surplus of $67.6 billion, fuelled, Mr. President, by a record-breaking run of 24 consecutive monthly trade surpluses from Australia. You have to go back, Mr. President, to 1972-73. To find the previous record. And indeed, it's fuelled in part by exports of goods surging up 13.4% in 2019 over 2018 levels, resources up, manufacturing exports up, rural exports also up, notwithstanding drought conditions. Yearly services exports also growing by 8.9%, recognising the diversification of our economy and crossing the $100 billion mark for our services exports for the first time ever, as we help to charge all aspects of the Australian economy.